Meghan Markle is expected to make her first trip to stay with the Queen at Balmoral next week along with Prince Harry, reports claim. But the Duchess, who follows a vegan diet during the week and has a history of animal activism, may choose to skip the blood sports. Sports like hunting and fly fishing are much-loved group activities at the Queen's summer retreat in the Scottish Highlands. Experts believe Meghan may choose to feign a headache to avoid salmon fishing in the River Dee and grouse shooting due to her beliefs. But Harry, who was taught to hunt from a young age, may decide to join in, although baby Archie may be too young to learn the ropes. The royal couple will just miss Prince William and Kate, as they returned home to Norfolk with George, Charlotte and Louis on Tuesday. The visits were not deliberately timed so the two families would avoid each other. Relations between the Fab Four have reportedly been strained since the Duke and Duchess of Sussex moved away from Kensington Palace to Windsor and split their respective households. Kate and William are understood to have had a lovely stay with the Queen and Prince Philip, along with Prince Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall. Barbecues and picnics are thought to take place daily at Balmoral, regardless of the Scottish weather, as the royals are so fond of all things outdoorsy. Writing for the Mail on Sunday, royal editor Robert Jobson said, "It is hunting which is perhaps the biggest passion." Meghan, however, who rather disapproves of such blood sports, may choose to feign a headache. The Queen shot her last stag in 1983 near to the Spittle of Glenmuick, in a spot that is now called the Queen's Quarry. But she still attends shoots and drove Kate to a grouse shoot when the couple visited a couple of years ago. Prince Andrew and Fergie also made the trip up to the Scottish retreat earlier this month. But it is understood that Fergie may cut short her week-long trip after Prince Philip arrived early for his summer holiday, reports claim. The Duke of Edinburgh supposedly refused to be in the same room as Sarah Ferguson for years after her divorce from Prince Andrew in 1996. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have been married for more than a year, but just before their wedding, the Queen rejected a request which changed their future lives together. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have now been married for more than a year, and have adorable son Archie Harrison, who was born in May. The Sussexes have plans to visit South Africa later this year, and have been getting used to life as a family of three. The couple lives in Frogmore Cottage in Windsor, not far from their wedding venue, St. George's Chapel. However, Frogmore Cottage was not their first choice of home, as the couple wanted to live in rather a grander setting, according to the Sunday Times. Meghan and Harry requested to live in Windsor Castle alongside Queen Elizabeth II. The report, written by Rose Anika, reads, "The couple are understood to have set their hearts at first on Windsor Castle, and are believed to have asked the Queen if living quarters could be made available after their marriage. However, the Queen declined their request, and instead offered them Frogmore Cottage, in the grounds of Home Park in Windsor." Royal author Hugo Vickers explained why the Queen might have turned Meghan and Harry down when it came to living in Windsor Castle. He said, "There are empty bedrooms and suites in the private apartments within Windsor Castle which the Sussexes may have had their eye on, or perhaps some former living quarters in the castle grounds converted into other things. But I can see how it might not be entirely appropriate to have a young family living there." Frogmore Cottage underwent extensive renovations for the Sussexes, as it had previously been staff residence, holding several apartments for royal workers. Renovations cost £2.4 million in public funds for a certain standard of kitchen, bathroom, flooring and fitted furniture, with anything considered a higher specification added to by Meghan and Harry privately. Sir Michael Stevens, keeper of the Privy Purse, who is responsible for monarchy's accounts, said of Frogmore Cottage, "The property had not been the subject of work for some years and had already been earmarked for renovation in line with our responsibility to maintain the condition of the occupied royal palace's estate." The sovereign grant covered the work undertaken to turn the building into the official residence and home of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex and their new family. The building was returned to a single residence and outdated infrastructure was replaced to guarantee the long-term future of the property. Substantially all fixtures and fittings were paid for by their royal highnesses. Now the 10-bedroom Grade 2 listed house is home to Meghan, Harry and their baby son Archie. Kensington Palace released a statement ahead of the Sussexes' wedding which read, "As with all members of the royal family, Windsor is a very special place for Prince Harry, and he and Ms. Markle have regularly spent time there over the last year and a half. Prince Harry and Ms. Markle are delighted that the beautiful grounds of Windsor Castle will be where they began their lives together as a married couple. The area is also special for the couple as they celebrated their wedding reception in nearby Frogmore House." Frogmore House is a 17th-century country house owned by the Crown Estate and has long been used as both a country retreat and place to entertain by the royal family. It was also the location of the Queen's grandson Peter Philip's wedding reception after he wed Autumn Kelly in May 2008.